Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on why your car may be vibrating at idle. A rough idle and vibration at idle has a lot of different underlying causes, so it can certainly be one of those frustrating issues that's very hard to diagnose and get to the bottom to, and that's especially true if you don't have any sort of check engine light or service engine soon light, and you have a code scanner and scan for codes but nothing pulled up. It can certainly be frustrating. So in this video, we are going to cover some of the most common causes of rough idle. Jumping right in, number one, we have the ignition system. The two main components within the ignition system that are likely to cause a rough idle are the spark plugs and ignition coils. So both of these components are responsible for essentially igniting the air-fuel mixture within the cylinder or the combustion chamber. And so if the ignition coil or spark plug is faulty or defective, it will not be able to fully ignite and combust that air-fuel mixture, which will then cause misfires and lead to a rough idle, especially if you're having a misfire at idle. So usually this problem will trigger a check engine light or a service engine soon light and also throw a misfire code. However, it's possible that won't happen. It is not always the case. And top that off with the fact, spark plugs and ignition coils are both wear and tear items depending on what car and engine you have. Typically, spark plugs last about 30,000 to 70,000 miles, and ignition coils can last roughly 60,000 to 150,000 miles. Again, that largely depends on what kind of engine you have. Typically, sporty or high performance engines, turbocharged, supercharged engines will have a shorter lifespan of those ignition components, whereas lower power, naturally aspirated engines will typically get a little bit more life out of these spark plugs and ignition coils. But ultimately, check your service manual, do a little bit of research. If you're out of the ballpark of that maintenance interval for the spark plugs or ignition coils and you have not changed those yet, that could be a good starting point, even if that isn't the ultimate cause of the rough idle. Again, that's something that should be done anyway, as spark plugs and ignition coils are standard wear and tear items, and it certainly won't hurt to get those replaced, especially if you're right near that mileage at the point that they should be replaced anyway. Moving on to number two on the list for common causes of rough idle and vibrations at idle, we have fuel system problems. So there are a couple different fueling related issues that can cause a rough idle. So number one, the fuel injectors are one major cause of rough idle. So you could have a leaking or a stuck fuel injector. Either way, if it's leaking and spraying a little too much fuel in the cylinder, or it's stuck or clogged and not spraying enough fuel, that can certainly lead to rough idle, stuttering, and a number of other problems. A few other fuel system issues are potential fuel leaks. If you have a fuel leak, you might not be getting enough rail pressure, enough pressure through those fuel injectors. You might have a clogged filter or a faulty high pressure and or low pressure fuel pump. So quite a few fueling system issues that can cause a rough idle. However, fuel pump issues and fuel injectors are certainly two of the more common issues with the fuel system. So definitely be on the lookout for that. Those can be more expensive fixes. So if you don't have anything pointing directly to the fuel system, that's probably something to hold off on. And just make sure you check all of the basics before doing more expensive repairs like replacing fuel injectors or fuel pumps. Moving on to number three, another common cause of rough idle is something that's mostly come up in the last couple decades as more and more cars and manufacturers have switched to using direct fuel injection instead of port fuel injection. And so the reason for the rough idle in some cases may be carbon buildup. Essentially what happens with direct injection is the fuel is sprayed directly into the cylinder. All engines have some degree of oil blow-by, which makes its way back into the intake tract and can stick to intake ports. So what happens is when that oil sticks to those ports, eventually it forms, it hardens, and you have now what's known as carbon deposits or carbon buildup. It can essentially restrict airflow into the cylinder, leading to uneven air fuel ratios and just an uneven airflow throughout the engine in general. So that's something that can certainly lead to issues with rough idle, stuttering, hesitation, power loss, things of that nature. So with carbon buildup, this was especially common on a number of BMW engines, as well as Volkswagen and Audi engines that use direct injection. Fortunately, most of the newest direct injection engines, especially the ones built after 2010, 2015-ish, a lot of the newest versions have very good PCV systems and are very good at limiting the amount of oil blowby and the amount of carbon buildup. However, without any fuel spraying over the intake ports and valves, there's no way to totally eliminate it. So if you have high mileage on a direct injection engine, that might be something to consider. It does require pulling off the intake manifold and physically cleaning off the carbon deposits from the intake valves and ports. So it's a little labor intensive, but does not cost very much. So if you are handy at DIYing things and you have a direct injection engine that's a little bit older and higher mileage, might be a good thing to consider walnut blasting those intake valves. Again, on port injected engines, which was the norm, and port injection is still common on many newer engines, it's just as direct injection has become more and more popular, carbon buildup causing rough idle is something that we see more and more often these days, so something that's certainly worth mentioning on this list of the most common causes of rough idle and vibrations at idle. Moving on to the next item on our list, at number 4, we have sensors. There are a lot of different sensors that can cause a rough idle, and this includes things like the mass airflow sensor, also known as the MAF or MAF sensor, the manifold absolute pressure sensor, also known as the MAP sensor, and things like O2 sensors, the oxygen sensors. So quite a few different sensors that measure airflow, air fuel ratios. If they're not reading correctly or they're completely defective, you'll suddenly not be getting the right amount of either air or fuel into the engine, and that can lead to misfires and rough idle. These aren't the only sensors that can cause rough idle and other related issues, definitely a couple other things. Exact sensors do depend on some different cars and models, but again, the MAF or MAF, the MAP sensor, and oxygen sensors are three of the most common ones to be on the lookout for if you are experiencing rough idles. If you do have problems with these sensors or a sensor in general, typically your car's computer will pick up on that and store a fault code as well as trigger a check engine light. So be sure to have a code scanner handy and plug that in. That'll certainly help you narrow down the exact problem, not just for these sensors, but that applies to many other issues that can cause rough idle. So just a quick tip. Moving on to number 5 on the list. This is something that is actually not necessarily directly related or tied into the engine, but we have engine and transmission mounts. Over time, these engine and transmission mounts can get worn down. As they wear down, they're no longer able to absorb impacts and vibrations as well as they once were. And so this is usually a little more noticeable with clunking or weird sounds, especially when hitting bumps or actually driving. However, those old worn motor or transmission mounts can certainly cause an increase in vibration at idle, and something that would be more noticeable within the cabin. If you own a car, especially if you have a car that's 10, 15 plus years old, those engine and transmission mounts are certainly something to consider. If you have a seriously rough idle, then it's unlikely to be engine and transmission mounts, but they certainly could be something contributing to the problem, especially if you have an older vehicle with a little bit of extra mileage. Moving on to the last item on our list here, at number 6, we have vacuum leaks. So vacuum leaks are another thing that are a very common cause of rough idle. It's something that is very important to engine operation, is having proper vacuum to control a bunch of various systems. So if you have any form of vacuum leak and you're losing that vacuum, then that can certainly lead to a rough idle. One of the easiest ways to check for a vacuum leak is simply doing a smoke test. That will help track down if you have any smoke actually seeping out of the vacuum lines or any connections. That can help track down that issue and figure out where the vacuum leak might be coming from. There are dozens and dozens of different things on an engine and on a vehicle that can cause a rough idle and vibrations at idle. So listing off a couple other things to be on the lookout for, it's always important when you have an issue like rough idle, again, have a code scanner, pull the code, see if anything comes up. Usually that can point you in the right direction, because most issues that lead to a rough idle should have an underlying failure that the car's computer is picking up on and storing that code in the ECU. So pulling that code should help point you in the right direction. Again, that is not always the case. So if you're in the situation where you have a rough idle and you don't have any codes, you don't have any engine light, you don't have anything to go off of, just start with the basics. Check your air filter, check how dirty it is. Is there anything blocking the air intake? Is there anything blocking the intake tract? Maybe you have tons of leaves or dirt and debris in your airbox somehow, but something to check because again, anything that really restricts air or fuel flow can cause rough idle and misfires. Things like spark plugs, ignition coils, wear and tear items, those are definitely good things to consider, even if that isn't the actual cause of the issue. If you know those are due up for replacement, just go ahead and knock that out and get those replaced since it's something good to do anyway. Ultimately, the point here is if you don't have anything to go off of, start with the basics. Don't just start buying a bunch of parts and throwing stuff on the car, hoping it's going to work out, unless in the case of the spark plug example that I gave briefly. Otherwise, if you're left with nothing else, no other ideas, then probably going to a shop and at least having them diagnose the issue or point you in the right direction might be your best bet. Because sometimes with these rough idles, you'll usually get an engine code and some sort of code stored within the DME or the ECU that you can look at and help point you in the right direction. But if you don't have that, sometimes it can be frustrating to have a rough idle and you might end up throwing hundreds of dollars in different parts at the car only for nothing to actually fix the issue. So if you're at dead ends, don't be afraid to go spend a little bit at a repair shop, at least get a diagnostic done, and that can help point you in the right direction to track and narrow down the issue at hand that's causing your rough idle. That wraps up our video for today. If you guys appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more awesome content. Thanks, guys.